this is why he died. This is now or never. It's not a time to hide. So what are we waiting for? Let's build his church. Thank you.
I needed rescue, my sin was heavy, but chains break at the weight of your glory. I needed shelter, I was an orphan, now you call me a citizen of heaven. When I was broken, you were my healing, now you're
Come on, welcome to church, y'all.
Who came here feeling like they're fighting something today? Can I tell you that the Lord is fighting on your behalf for you? I love this song because it reminds me of David and Goliath. And if you know David and Goliath, Goliath is challenging David's army, trying to defeat them and taunt them. And nobody's willing to stand up against Goliath. But David goes to King Saul and he says, hey, I'll stand up and I'll fight this giant. But then King Saul begins to doubt David. But I love how David responds. He says in 1 Samuel 17:37, the Lord who rescued me from the paw of the lion and the paw of the bear will rescue me from the hand of this Philistine. See, what David did was he declared his victory before he even stepped into the battle. And maybe you're here in this place facing something, and this is your chance to declare your victory before you step in. And it goes like this. You take what the enemy meant for evil, and you turn it for good. You turn it for good. Come on, that's all it is. Say it with your mouth. You take what the enemy meant for evil, and you turn it for good. You turn it for good. Oh, I know it's true. You take what the enemy meant for evil, and you turn it for good. You turn it for good. Oh, I know it's every time. You take what the enemy meant for evil, and you turn it for good. Thank you. just receive the power of God where you're at. So that's where breakthrough happens. That's where breakthrough happens. There's no circumstance unseen. Come on, we testify this. There will be victory here. There will be victory here. There will be victory here. Oh, there will be victory here. There will be victory. Example of a father. And so maybe it's hard to acknowledge God as Father. But can I tell you that the Heavenly Father does not reflect your earthly father? That the Heavenly Father is actually indeed a good, good Father, right? And so, man, I just feel like in this moment that there's some of us in here that we just need to pause and sit and listen and hear from our Father how much He delights in us, how much He desires to hear from us, how much He desires to know from us. So let's take this moment and let's just listen. Hey, Dad, what do you have to say to me? We're gonna wait on the Lord to come in this place.
Show me who you are. that's all it is. Sing holy, 'cause holy, there is no one like you.
There is none beside you.
Oh,
doesn't matter who you are, doesn't matter what your past is, doesn't doesn't matter the situation that you're in, the thing that you're struggling in right now. Everyone is welcome to enter in the presence of God. If your marriage is on the rocks, you've experienced a failed marriage, you're able to enter into the presence of God. If you've struggled with alcohol or you continue to struggle with alcohol, you're able to enter into the presence of God still. See, the presence of God isn't this place where you have to get right before you can enter in. You don't have to get it right before you accept the cross. The cross was dirty. It was brutal. There's nothing more, I can't imagine a more graphic scene than the cross, than Jesus on the cross. And he's not saying, I think he did that, because he's saying, hey, I'm holding your mess. I'm willing to get this messy for you. You can come to me dirty. You can come to me unclean. And what happens when you do come to me dirty and you do come to me unclean? I clean you, I wash you, and I make you whole. It's his crimson blood that washes us white as snow, right? And so when we hear, when we're worshiping, and as we go into this next song, we're not seeking after the hand of God, but we're seeking the face of God, the person of God, the person of Jesus. Because we know our relationship with God, our relationship with Jesus is not about what he can do for us, but it's about what he's already done, and it's just about who he is. So Jesus, enter this room right now. Here in this place, God, into those online. Enter their living room, their cars. God, it's your presence that we want. And we realize we don't need to be perfect to receive it.
Oh, it chases me down.
shadow, you won't light up. Mountain, you won't climb up. Coming after me. There's no wall you won't kick down. High, you won't tear down. Coming after me. There's no shadow you won't hide up. Mountain, you won't climb up. Coming after me. There's no wall you won't kick down, lie you won't tear down. Coming.